Hey, the Daily Purge. Today I want to ask you a simple question. Is the world really as bad as we think it is? I mean, do we live in the world that we think we live in? I mean, some people might say, oh, here we go with the hokey talking again. Well, you know, it's a valid question, and I'll tell you why. Because what we hear every day, what we talk about every day, what people talk about every day, what people tell us every day, is their opinion. It's their thoughts. It's what they perceive in the world right now. It's important, or it is more than not. It's the message about what supports their belief of what the world is. So what does that tell you about what the world is? It sort of tells you, hey, Crystal, it sort of tells you that when we listen to other people talk about the world and reality, their reality, we're listening to their opinion of it. So are we looking through a camera and accepting it as it is? Or are we framing it in our reality? Or do we realize that we create our own reality? Or are we one with the world and sort of understanding that the reality that's out there is something that we can either think about, believe, not think about, focus on the now, focus on the past, the present, and the future? All these things I talk about all the time. I think everyone knows very well my opinion on these things. I'm trying to hold this camera right. And morning. And I feel like when I come to places like I'm at right now, which is the war memorial, the Hungarian war memorial right here, right? That's a reality that actually happened. Those guys went and they fought and they died, just like our Memorial Day over the weekend was for the fallen soldiers and the airmen and the Marines, the Air Force, and sorry, Marines, Navy, and who am I forgetting? Coast Guard. So that's a reality that happened. Question is, how do you frame that reality and how do you accept that into your life? I mean, one of the things that I learned over the years from losing a friend in battle was that I sort of owe it to them. That's my belief. I owe it to them to live the best life, step into my greatness, and be the best that I can be. I'd be letting them down if I didn't do that. So let's talk about COVID. Let's talk about the world at hand and all the stuff's going on and the police murdering an innocent man, all these kind of things. They're going to weigh us down. They're going to weigh us down. And so I woke up this morning thinking, man, what kind of a shithole are we living in? What's going on with this world? And I was sort of depressed, I got to tell you. And then I started, hey, Marquez, how you doing, man? So I started asking myself, well, why am I thinking about this stuff? What does it do for me? What does it do for me to watch that video of a police officer killing an innocent man? What does it actually do for me? Some people would say, well, it makes you aware of what's actually going on in the world. Yeah, well, that happened, and it did, and we can't ignore that. And those guys should be brought to justice. They should be put in jail, at the minimum, in my opinion. But that doesn't help me any of that. It doesn't help me in my world. It doesn't help me move forward. It doesn't help me with my business. It doesn't help me with my mindset. And, you know, mindset's a funny thing, because mindset, sometimes we think, okay, I can control my mind, I can control what's going on in my mind, so let me just control that. And what we end up doing is creating a diversion of what's going on. So what I did this morning is I put on my favorite audiobook and went to the gym, and I'm sitting there, and it didn't work. It didn't work like it usually does. And I thought to myself, well, man, I'm just diverting myself, aren't I? Oh, Crystal, so sorry to hear about that. God dang. Oh my God, that's so sad. So, so sorry, Crystal. Wow, I don't know what to say to that. Man. You know, that's another thing that actually happened that, you know, we got to deal with and figure out how to move on, because every negative thing, everything that keeps us at bay, everything that keeps us away from our greatness is a diversion, whether it's true or not. More than often, it's our thoughts that we're worried about and not actually what's going on. So my action after putting that audiobook on was, man, well, if I can't get into a better mindset through my audiobooks, which in the end may be learning, but it's also a diversion to get my mind off whatever my mind was thinking about. And, you know, my mind was thinking about something that really happened, and that was that cop killing that man innocently. So what am I to do? So what I did is I chose another audiobook that I knew was, it's called The Inside Out Revolution. You should read it. I think, Crystal, I told you about it. Is I put that in, and that started reminding me again that, man, everything that we think about is something that we're creating. we're creating that thought. We're creating what we're thinking about. Hey, Stephen DePue, we're creating what we're thinking about, and we're creating often negativity. We're creating no benefit for ourselves at all. Okay, sure, you may have knowledge. You can talk about it, you know, at the local bar or wherever you go with your friends and have knowledge about what's going on in your world, and that's great and fun and whatever, but what does it do for your business? What does it do for your world? What does it do for your family? What does it do for anything? And, you know, I went home after the gym, still wasn't in a great mood. Listening to that book made me realize the reality, and it reminded me of one thing. And man, this is going to sound hokey, but it reminded me of one thing. What I have in my life is what I have to be grateful for. And I feel like I went home and I saw my kids and my wife, and I embraced the moment, and I felt like, wow, you know what? I'm the luckiest man in the world. This right here, this is real. My family, it's real. My kids, we created them together, and they're a part of me, right? That's incredible. Now see, that helps me. That's a driving force. That's what they would call, that's what they would call my why, right? My why, which I hate talking about because it's so superficial. So I came back to myself and I said, okay, I'm grateful for my family, grateful for my kids, and grateful for the fact that we live in a great house and in a great small community, and we love what's going on. Hey, Michael, how you doing, brother? We know what's going on in the world, in our little world. And it goes back to the same thing all the time. The only thing that we can influence is our immediate world. That's the only thing we can influence. The people you know, where you live, what you eat, what you do, how you work, all these things, we can influence that. And if we allow the outside world to influence us, we're hurting ourselves, we're hurting our jobs, we're hurting our revenue, we're hurting whoever we are. So the focus has to be, hey Vicky, how you doing? The focus must and has to be on our world. That's the only place we can change it. And the thing about it is, a lot of times we let our past dictate our future. So you have an experience in the past, something happens, you relate back to what happened before. Oh, I know what happens now because that happened before. Well, we're allowing ourselves to be programmed. So do we allow ourselves to be programmed? Do we consciously take an effort to create a world where it doesn't have to be like that? Our world, our immediate world, the world around us, the world that we can actually influence? Or do we allow that outside sort of like looking through a camera lens as if we're watching a TV? You can't change the world. It's like watching a TV series and talking to the people on TV, and we've all done it. Hey, don't do that, you're gonna get killed. Like a horror movie. Don't go there, you're gonna get killed. You can't change it, it's a film. It's past, it's done, it's over. The only thing you can change is in the future, and you can make your own film to make it the way you want it to be made. And that's my point for today. Creating our own reality. It's like making your own film, right? It's like creating your own film. You don't like the way a film ran? Make your own film. And so the same thing we can do with our lives. How do you create that day every day that's going to be the greatest day of your life? How do you create that day every day that's going to be the most productive day in your life? How do you create that day every single day that's going to bring you the most revenue? Well, it all comes down to one thing, and that's belief, right? It's belief and faith. You know, I believe very, very, very deeply that belief is an active mode of thinking. So I believe I can, I believe I will, and this kind of stuff. And then it comes to faith. And faith is sort of like when you're praying, you say, God, please take me here and take me there and get this and get that. But a lot of people who have faith, they pray for the same thing over and over and over. And that sort of shows the truth that they really don't have faith. They're only stuck on belief. And then there comes certainty and knowing. And once you know, you don't think anymore. It just is. Hey, Richard, how you doing, brother? It just is. So that's my message for you today. Be conscious of what's going on around you. Be conscious of what those thoughts and the news you watch and the people that you talk to and the conversations you have, how much it really impacts your life and those around you. Because everything that you exude from your person goes to the next person and creates radiant value or radiant negativity or radiant anything worse than greatness. And we don't need that. No one needs that. I don't want it, actually. So all these negative posts and all these negative people and all this negativity in the news and stuff, I take it for what it is. It's a grain of salt, but it's their reality. It's not my reality. So is the world really that bad? Well, yeah, it is if you look at it through a camera and like it's a TV series. Or you can say, no, the world isn't that bad. I'm going to create my own movie. I'm going to create my own world. I'm going to stop looking through it like it's a TV show and start being in the show myself and creating that massive reality that I want to have in my life that can have immediate impact in my little world, my life enterprise, we like to call it. All right, so that's my tip for you today. Look, a lot of this we talk about in our book, Unleash Your Humble Alpha. Go ahead and grab it. It's in the link underneath or above this video. And I wish you guys a fantastic day. I really, really do. This is our world, man. This is our world. It's what we make out of it. Not, no one, you know, everyone thinks, oh, the politicians rule. They don't rule. They don't rule. We let them rule, okay? We let them rule. We can let them rule or we can rule our own worlds. It's up to you. That's what I wish for you guys. Rule your own world. Have it. And start creating more quality of life. See you guys later. Thanks.